It's Gibraltar's largest fundraiser. We've raised around £4 million now since the 1980s, which is a phenomenal amount of money. Last year, we raised £128,000, slightly down on the previous 3 or 4 years, but it was not to be, it was to be expected because of the pandemic and the fact that we did 2 open days last year. And it's important for the public service broadcaster, which is central to the lives of everybody who lives in our community, to be spearheading this. And not only entertaining people, but also helping those in need.
Well, we didn't want to be here again in the middle of a pandemic, but here we are. What can we expect?
Well, we've tried to make this open day as normal as possible, despite the pandemic. We'll, of course, have social distancing measures down in Main Street tomorrow during the radio roadshow, and we'll make sure that people here in the TV show are also moved around in ways which are socially distant as well. It's important to do that in this day and age to keep everybody as safe as possible, but at the same time of being able to have a show that people expect and which will entertain people and which will have the same aims as it's always had. And for the first time, doing the television show from our new studios here at New Broadcasting House.
And you said that we've raised quite a lot of money over the years. Can you just give us a sense how that money is used, particularly over the past year?
We've been able to assist several very worthy causes. Society for Cancer Relief Gibraltar has taken £50,000. Also, we've contributed a sizable amount of money to the Unity Foundation that's during 2022 will be conducting events and initiatives for young people who will be able to benefit from this, young people who may be in care or who may have other issues. And the Unity Project aims to assist them. Also, we've managed to purchase new instruments for the Gibraltar Sea Scout Band that does so much for the community throughout the year. So the open day is on the ascendance, and despite a little blip last year where perhaps enthusiasm wasn't as great as previous years because of the pandemic, this year I've noticed quite the opposite of companies pledging substantial donations. Big bargain bonanza that's already taken place just a few moments ago has had 65 items there, high value items that we've been able to sell as well. So plenty for people to be able to buy and to donate through. But of course, the enthusiasm has come from the business community and individuals alike who've been able to support us in a huge way this year. And I'm sure that tomorrow will be very successful.